Hello everyone, welcome to PD's Research Bites. In this video, I am going to talk about R number. All of you must have heard about R number these days. Ever since the COVID-19 pandemic began, R number is hitting the headlines. Let us look at some of the headlines related to R number. COVID-19 UK's R number rises slightly between 1 and 1.4. From India, coronavirus India, India's R factor goes below 1. Here is what it means. Times of India reported last year. From Germany, tracking coronavirus spread in Germany. How many people are ill? How many have recovered? What about the R value? Yahoo News reported the European country that has brought the R rate below 1. So the purpose of this video is to give some basic understanding about R number. I am not going into the technical details of calculation, etc. So this video is meant for a general audience, not for epidemiologists, statisticians or modelers who wants to know the calculation and technical aspects about R number. So let us see what is this R number. R, or the reproduction number, indicates how quickly an infection is spreading. The origin of R number is from demography. A century back, it used to represent the population growth. But in epidemiology, it indicates how the infection is spreading. So in demography, whether the population is growing or not growing. So in epidemiology, whether the infection is spreading or not spreading. So R is the number of people that one infected person will pass on a virus to another person. It will tell us how slow or fast the virus is spreading, similar to the population growth. Some more details. How do we interpret this R number? We hear a lot about this number in the headlines. So how do we interpret this? So as we have seen, it means on an average, one person will spread COVID-19 to another person. So when R is 1, it means one infected individual could pass on the infection to another person. So when R is 2, it means one infected individual could pass on the infection to two individuals. So when R is 0.5, it means like one infected person can pass on the infection to half a person. But in reality, to be more realistic, it means two infected people can pass on the infection to one person, one another person. Why is a number above 1 dangerous? We hear a lot about these days, like R number is above 1. That means we have to take precautions, there will be some measures taken, and it is something dangerous and there will be alert everywhere. So when R number has risen above 1, this means the epidemic is growing. So when it is equals to 1, it is stabilizing. So when R is less than 1, that means it is good news, the epidemic is slowing down. What is the significance of R number? So we hear a lot about R number, that it impacts the government policies, major decisions are taken, and then it also shows like how the country is responding to the pandemic, etc. So it helps the government in making policy decisions. It shows how well the country is responding to pandemic, and also it indicates the preventive public health measures, whether it is effective or not, such as social distancing, school closure, etc. And also it helps to plan additional intervention. When the R number is going up, there will be additional measures in place to reduce the infection. So it's very significant. However, R should be interpreted very carefully. I will be talking about that in the following slides. Before that, let us see. R number is just the R number. Just it is a reproduction number. Or it has some variations. So usually it is either R0 or RT or RE. So what is R0? R0 or R0 is the basic reproduction number. RT or RE is the effective reproduction number. So to be more precise, just to know some difference between R0 and RE. R0 or the basic reproduction number assumes that there is no pre-existing immunity in the community because they have not had the previous exposure to the virus. So everyone is susceptible. So this will reflect more in the initial phases of the pandemic, that there is no pre-existing immunity, all are susceptible, it is a new virus, etc. So it works in the initial phases of the pandemic, and it is also influenced by factors such as frequency of contact, likelihood of infection in each contact, and the duration of contagiousness. So what is more relevant now is the next one, that is RT, which is a time-dependent reproduction number, or it is otherwise called effective reproduction number. Most often it is there will be only just R number mentioned. Sometimes it will be more clearly mentioned whether it is RT or RO or R0. So RE, or the effective reproduction number, which is time dependent, it is the number of people that can be infected by an individual. The definition is same, but it is influenced by vaccination, acquiring natural immunity, and by preventive public health measures such as social distancing. So that RT, or the effective reproduction number, reflects the current scenario or the ongoing situation of pandemic. So these days when we hear about R, as the pandemic is ongoing, it is related to the effective reproduction number, not about the basic reproduction number. How R number is calculated? I think these technical details are not important for all of us. It is important for some people which do the calculation, modeling and epidemiologists, all of them, it is very important. R, or this number, is calculated using a statistical package. It's R software, and there are various methods to estimate the basic reproduction number and effective reproduction number. Those who are interested in knowing the details, I have given some reference. You can go through that. Otherwise, the materials, so many materials are available in the internet. So the purpose of the video is to have a basic understanding, not to go into the technical details. So the most important aspect is R a reliable tool to monitor the pandemic situation? There are a lot of discussions and debates about over-relying on R number. So whether we have to depend so much on the R number, or everything around R number, we have to plan things around the R number, or we have to interpret this number cautiously. It works well if we have an up-to-date and comprehensive data. It could be used alongside with other data such as surveillance data, trends in number of new infections, deaths, hospital admissions, testing data, etc. It should not be used in isolation. As the number estimate an average for a population, it is difficult to determine local variation. This is one of the major limitations. It can miss regional cluster of infection, like super spreading events, super spreaders, localized cluster of infection, it can miss. On the other hand, high incidence of localized infection can influence the regional R value or the country specific R values. So it can influence both ways. So we have to be careful in interpreting the R value in a more general way. It is also important to have regular testing of the entire country's population to measure R in real time. So those scientists who does modeling look at current and previous number of cases and death and estimate R numbers. So in general, R number has to be interpreted carefully, and other parameters has to be considered, so we have to look at the comprehensive look at the scenario. So these are the references I used. I use more references. I have given some important ones. It's very good to read the details, those who are interested. So thanks for watching the video. Goodbye.